And we have our last panelist presentation for this section. She's a project manager at STUK, the Finnish regulator of nuclear technologies. Her name's Minna Tuomainen, and come on up here. How did I do on your name? Like, pretty good?
It was correct. Pretty good.
All right, good practicing.
Okay, I think we are ready to continue. So, good morning to everyone. I am Minna Tuomainen from STUK, and I work with licensing of new reactors. I was the project manager for licensing of Olkiluoto 3, but now Olkiluoto 3 was granted the operating license some weeks ago. So, actually, my title changed. This Monday, I'm not more a project manager, and actually, I'm not quite sure what my title is at the moment, but Minna Tuomainen from STUK, and STUK is, of course, the Nuclear Radiation Safety Authority of Finland. And thank you for inviting STUK here today. It's essential for us to hear what is going on and to hear the opinions from the industry so we can also prepare ourselves for the future. I will first tell you a little bit about how nuclear facilities are licensed in Finland at the moment. Then I will discuss that what could be different for SMR licensing. And also, finally, I will say some words about international cooperation. So, nuclear facilities need a license in Finland. And there are four main licensing steps in the life cycle of a facility. First one is the decision in principle, and then after that there are construction license before the actual construction work can begin, then operating license before start of operation, and finally decommissioning license to allow the decommissioning activities to start. And these all are government decisions. The decision in principle, it also needs to be ratified by the parliament. And the decision in principle is more about energy policy, and it is a debate about the question that whether building this new facility is for the overall good of society. But then the later phases, construction, operating and decommissioning licenses, they concentrate mainly on safety and in the technical issues, and there is no more political debate at those stages. And those decisions need not to be ratified by the parliament. And at each stage, STUK's role is to make a safety assessment, and that means that we assess whether the proposed facility fulfills the Finnish safety requirements. But this current licensing model and also the more detailed requirements, they have been written for individual large light water reactors. It is not said in the legislation that you cannot license any other kind of facilities, but that has been the mindset when the licensing model has been created and when the requirements has been written, that no one would ever license anything else than individual large light water reactors. So we know very well that the current licensing model and the requirements may not be feasible for licensing SMRs. Yep. And then next I will discuss that how it would be possible to make licensing SMRs easier. And first of all, before we really can do anything major concerning this, a clear decision on a national level would be needed that SMR is the way to go, that this is where the society wants to invest in. And then this kind of decision should then be reflected in the resources. For example, for competence building, and then for renewal of legislation. The fact is that at the moment we have very limited resources to do any of this work. We have some resources to participate in seminars like this and participate in some international cooperation, but we don't really have resources to start evaluation of some concepts or to start this big renewal of the legislation. And here the Ministry of Economic Affairs and Employment, we think that they should have a leading role in this discussion and decision making, and it will be very interesting today to hear their opinions on this question. Some thoughts about what we think for licensing of SMRs. This may sound a little bit depressing and restrictive and scary when we say that the same level of safety is expected from SMRs than from large reactors or from other facilities, and also that the level of safety has to be demonstrated. But this is not maybe as bad as it may sound. So this level of safety, if I simplify a little bit, it mainly means that the radiation doses to people as a consequence of the operation of the facility or of some possible accidents, and also the allowed contamination of the environment, they are the acceptations concerning those are the same for whether it is SMR or large reactor. And of course, it might very well be that for SMR concepts, it's very much easier to reach this safety level than what it is with the large reactor. And this does not mean that the SMR should fulfill all the same detailed requirements as large reactors, because there might be and there are some requirements that are not really applicable to some SMR concepts. So I believe that at least with some SMR concepts, it's really very much easier to reach the same safety level than with some large reactor concepts. For example, just because the amount of radioactive substances in the reactor is so much smaller than in large reactors. So this is not as depressing as it may sound. Then here I must first of all warn you that these are just very preliminary ideas what could be different for SMRs. These changes to the licensing model has not yet been discussed properly, not with the ministry, not even within STUK, but these are some preliminary ideas that we have discussed to some extent, and also we are using the experiences from the other regulators from around the world that how they are licensing or planning to license SMRs. And some changes that could be made to the current licensing model is for example that the site could be approved separately, because at the moment the reactor and site, they are treated from the very beginning together. So in the construction license phase, we evaluate both the site and the reactor concept, but this could be separated and the site could be approved already quite much earlier than when some utility wants to then apply for a construction license. And one question about siting that we have a little bit discussed is this requirements for these emergency planning zones that in the present legislation, I think there are some zones of 5 and 20 kilometers, not depending on what kind of facility you are building, that where you have to have this emergency preparedness. But we know that those may probably are not feasible for SMRs, and with some SMRs at least you could demonstrate that smaller zones can be used. So this is one question that we know that could be changed for SMRs. But then maybe even, or probably more important than this separate site approval, is this design certification that, for example, is used in the US, so that the vendor could apply design certification for their reactor, and then any utility could then use that reactor, and the design would not be evaluated again in the construction license phase. And then if so, the construction license evaluation could focus on the possible changes made after the design certification and then on the licensee's performance. Then there is also this question that if there is a facility with several reactor modules, are they all included in the same license, or does every one of them has their own license? This is not a very big question. It is just then must be thought that what is practical. And for example, at the moment, Olkiluoto 1 and 2, they are included in the same operating license. So this is not a big question. But then, of course, this would mean big changes to this current licensing model. And this really should be discussed with the ministry, and because they are responsible for this model. And of course, there is also this question that is it necessary for these later phases after decision in principle, like construction license, operating license, decommissioning license, do they need to be government decisions, or could they be made on lower level without involving the government? But that is, of course, not up to STUK, but up to the ministry. Then, in some aspects, SMRs are very different from the large reactors, and here are just some examples of specific questions. This is by no means comprehensive. These are just some examples. For example, in the legislation, there are requirements and obligations for the licensee. And if there are many new licensees, many new utilities, municipalities who want to license SMRs, these requirements could be a challenge for these new operators that don't have any previous competence or experience about using nuclear energy. Then waste management is another question, and we think that it would be good to find some national solution to waste management, and it would be beneficial to have one company or one organization or whatever that would in a centralized way take care of the waste management instead of each separate utility or municipality trying to do that by themselves. Then the operating concept may be very different from the traditional nuclear power plants. There could be remote operation or unmanned stations. And in that case, there are these questions of security, cybersecurity safeguards that may need some novel approaches to ensure the safety. And then the title of this presentation, I think in the program, was international licensing, but I changed it a little bit because such thing doesn't really exist at the moment. So, but I have something about international cooperation concerning SMR licensing. So formal international licensing has not really been discussed with any concrete ideas or proposals. But alternative to this formal licensing could be some kind of a joint safety assessment of chosen designs. And this has been attempted. There are some cases. Finland has not been involved, but there have been other cases of this joint assessment, and in order for it to be successful, it's important that the safety goals and the requirements against which this evaluation is done are agreed. And this may be a challenge because all countries have their own requirements, their own legislation, and it has been noticed that it's sometimes, or it is difficult to harmonize it, that what really is the basis against which this kind of assessment is made. On European level, this harmonization of safety approaches is done within VENRA, which is a Western European Nuclear Regulators Association. We have asked VENRA that should SMRs be included in the scope, and I think that there is next week meeting of VENRA, where this probably will be discussed. Then we participate in a forum for SMR regulators. It is supported by IAEA, and there the objective is not to harmonize regulations or requirements, but to identify that what could be challenges in licensing SMRs and try to find ways to find answers to these challenges. And I think that was my last slide, so thank you.